Hi everyone. I've been on a video kick, as most of you have probably already noticed. Now, I've made this video a few days ago, but what happened was when I uploaded it said the download failed, and then when I tried uploading it again, the video was deleted. The enemy took down the video. So now I'm remaking this video, guys. The title of this video is Hearing God and Testing the Spirits. Now, I'm going to be posting some links in the description settings of this video. I made a video in the past titled True Intimacy with Christ is Dying to Self. And in that video, I've made some things known in the different ways God will speak and why he may speak to you in the way that he will speak to you. So I'm going to post that in the description settings. Hopefully you take the time to look at that. And I'll also post a playlist titled Hearing God's Voice slash Relationship with Christ, where you have the opportunity to just take the time to look at some of those videos to just help you out within your walk. I'm going to be speaking from, my experiences, what has helped me. Now, of course, it all comes with discernment. Well, for one, you have a lot of people who don't believe that God can speak to you. You have to remember the Bible says that his sheep hear his voice. He knows us and we follow him. He does have a voice. Just as you are able to hear me, he can speak in that way, his audible voice. He speaks in many ways. You can talk to your mom, your dad, a relative, a friend. You're able to talk with them. Of course, you can have a relationship with the Creator. Why not, guys? It is a matter of believing. It's impossible to please him without faith. We need to have faith, but if you don't believe, then of course you place limits on him and he won't do it. But it is a matter of believing, guys. He does speak. And what happens is we place limitations on God. Sometimes we just limit him to the Bible only, when in fact he speaks through everything. He could speak through people, the Holy Spirit speaking out of people. He could speak through the written word, of course. He speaks through nature. He speaks through his creation, the sun and moon. It's just because we are so accustomed to placing God within a box, we have difficulty in understanding the different ways he may speak, or not paying close attention to the other ways he may speak, because he does speak in many ways. It is a matter of just needing to really pay attention to how he's speaking. When we are really into the things of the world, we're not really in tune with God, it can make it difficult for us to really and truly hear him, which is why it is a matter of needing to surrender and die to self. When you start crucifying the flesh, dying to your wants, your desires, your mindsets, your way of thinking, and you humble yourself before him, you begin to tune him in. It becomes easier in being able to hear him and discern as well. We do need the gift of discernment, because just as God can talk to you, the enemy can also talk to you as well. God, he can speak through dreams, he can speak through visions. The enemy can also try to do that, which is important, why you really and truly need to test the spirits. And we're gonna be going off into more detail momentarily, guys. But yes, God, he meets you where you are at in your walk. So based on where you're at in your walk, he will speak to you based on where you're at in your walk. He could speak through music. He had to also keep in mind, I believe it was either in Songs or in Proverbs, he created the wicked for his intended use. He can also use the wicked to get your attention. He has ways of getting your attention, guys, because everything that happens works out for our good. If God is for us, not even your own enemies can be against you. So you really and truly need to keep that in mind when it comes to hearing God, to not place limits on God, because he can speak through any and everything. He's sovereign. He can do whatever he wants, guys. So it is a matter of need to pay attention and discern, praying for the gift of discernment. But when it comes to really and truly testing the spirits, it is a matter of need to have experience. For an example, you have the babes in Christ who still may not know. You have the toddlers who are able they're able to discern the voice of God. They still may struggle every now and then. And then you have the mature, those who have mastered hearing the voice of God. But it comes with experience. It comes with having to make mistakes, because if you don't gain the experience, how would you be able to really and truly discern? But you also have to keep in mind too, just as you have earth parents, you're able to know when your parents are speaking. It's the same thing with the Father. You know when he is speaking to you, and especially when you have the Holy Spirit living on the inside of you. The Holy Spirit helps you in being able to test the spirits and gain an understanding, because your spirit will bear witness to what's true, what is not true. And when you are doing things, for an example, when you're going in prayer and you're asking God something, he shows you things, you go back to the Bible to test it, to just confirm things. You can also do that as well. He speaks in many ways, guys. based on where you are at in your walk and whether or not, how keen you are when it comes to the discerning. Now, when it came to me, what happens is he will grow you in the different ways he speaks. For an example, you may have mastered him speaking in the Bible, and he may start speaking to you through music. Once you master that, he may start speaking to you through some other area. You begin to witness to the different ways he'll speak, and when you master one area, he'll grow you in another, he'll grow you in another to expand your faith. Now, one thing I've noticed, he does have an audible voice. I've noticed God don't too much speak in his audible voice unless he's really and truly trying to get your attention, because you could be missing out on something. It's something you're not understanding, or either you falling for some type of deception, you're being a rockhead and he's really trying to get your attention. Or you could be a person who may not really know him, so you can fully hear him. He will use an audible voice, and sometimes he'll just use his audible voice because that's just something that he chooses to do. But he'll really and truly speak through thoughts as well, guys. He does that a lot. It's a matter of you need to discern the difference between him speaking, the enemy speaking, and you speaking. Because you have to keep in mind, before coming to Christ, we do have the things in our heart, desires within our heart. In the book of Jeremiah, it talks about how the heart is deceiving. So we have certain things within our heart that need to come out. And sometimes when we are trying to discern, it may be us answering the question. Like, we may ask God a question and our hearts may respond for us. The desires that's in our hearts that may not be of God, which is why we do need to just surrender, humble ourselves, and allow him to purify and purge our hearts to make us more to his image. As we're being transformed more to his image, it becomes easier in being able to hear and discern when it's him, when it's not him. Again, his sheep hear his voice, he knows us, and we follow him. So it is a matter of need to surrender and die to self. I've noticed when you are a person, you may have pain in your heart, like you're holding on to pride. That can really hinder you in hearing God, especially if you are a person who have unforgiveness or bitterness or some hatred towards God. That can really and truly stop you and block you from hearing God. It is a matter of need to, get rid of that. And if you're a person who has unbelief, getting rid of that as well. I post a playlist on in this description sentence of this video titled "Being Healed Within," slash surrendering, as well as the video that I spoke of regarding unbelief, because there are people who do have unbelief. It is a matter of need to get rid of that, because that will truly stop you from hearing God. So, pride can be blinding. That can stop you, that can hinder you. So yeah, it is a matter of just need to surrender and die to self, because the more you die to self, you becoming alive in the spirit, the easier it gets in being able to hear. Now, when it comes to testing the spirit, you do have the First John test, where it talks about how no spirit of the Antichrist spirit cannot acknowledge that Jesus came in the flesh. So when you are trying to test the spirits, you can also ask, you can when you're asking a question or you hear something, you can ask, "Do you acknowledge that Jesus Christ came in the flesh?" and listen to the response. If you hear a voice say, "Yes, I acknowledge that I've came in the flesh," you know it's the Lord. If they say no, or they don't say anything at all, or they could be stalling, more than likely it's not the Lord, and you need to rebuke that and cast it to, the pits of hell where it belongs. So that is one way that the Bible speaks of when it comes to testing the spirits. And the more you grow accustomed to discerning and experiencing, it gets easier. That's what separates the babes in Christ from the toddlers, from the mature, when it comes to hearing the voice of God, I should say. So, that is definitely a way. Your spirit will definitely bear witness. It is a matter of needing to get your heart and mind on one accord with God's will, so you're able to know, what's the perfect will of God. Renewing the mind, that does play a role. When you are in prayer and he's showing you something, you can take that back to scripture, because it will line up what the written word of God says, and to just not place limits on God and how he may choose to speak. He speaks through thoughts. What I've noticed is too, I've been able to really discern the difference between the Holy Spirit when it's the Lord speaking and when it's the Father speaking. Now, like with the Holy Spirit, you will feel something in your stomach. It will start off in your stomach, and what happens is it will travel up to your mind as a thought. That's, the Holy Spirit will speak in that way. There have been times where God has laid things on my heart. I felt something hit my heart and it traveled up to my mind as a thought. God would do that a lot too. He was speaking that way. And when it came with me, he only spoke with me. He speaks to me in that way. When it's something that, like, I'm really not paying attention, he really wants me to grasp it, to really get my attention. He will lay something on my heart hard, and I'm able to hear what it is that he's speaking. But for the most part, it's really a matter of thoughts, or the Holy Spirit, may speak through a person, and I hear, I can discern that, and I feel the conviction and things, guys. So he will grow you in the different ways of how he speak. A faith builder, faith strengthener, when you think about it. Now, as I say, I've been able to discern the difference between when the Father speaks, when the Lord speaks, and when the Holy Spirit speaks. Now, the Father, I've heard him maybe like two, three, not, I heard the Lord more, speak more so than the Father, but when they spoke, I've been able to discern difference within their voices. They're pretty distinct, so I'm able to know when it's the Father speaking and when it's the Lord who is speaking. Of course, in a loving tone, nothing fierce or mean, and I'm not saying this to try to minimize the character of Christ, because he is open and honest. He will tell you the truth and things, but that was just what I've experienced. I've been able to discern all three of them. Now, this is also during the time. There's one point where I didn't understand the Trinity, guys. I'm going to post that video in the description settings of this video, because I admit I was kind of confused about the Trinity. I was looking at Jesus Christ as being the Father and things, and because the Bible says three bear record in heaven. Again, I'm going to post that video in the description settings. I don't want to argue with anyone when it comes to the Trinity. Some people are just very debative. Nope, we're not going to be doing that on this channel, guys. I'm just clarifying that now. So, again, I post that video, and the Father taught me about that. I was able to get more of an understanding of the Trinity as I was praying, and he revealed things and hit my spirit, and I was able to hear that it was the Father speaking, not the Lord Jesus speaking. But again, it comes with having to experience, because if you're not experiencing, you're not going to know. So as you're experiencing, there will be times where you may make mistakes, you may mess up, but it's part of the journey, guys, because we're not going to get everything right off the rip. It takes having to experience. So the more you go through it, the easier it is for you to discern. It builds up your discernment and being able to discern the voices, and it gets easier as time goes on. But one thing I really would suggest is really and truly start discerning the thoughts, because God will really and truly speak to you through thoughts. A lot of the things that you may think of on a day-to-day basis may not even be your thought. It could have been an enemy who could have placed a thought in your mind, because he will bring the spirit of distractions to try to get you distracted. You will have the Father will put things on your mind to remind you of things. Yeah, he does speak it that way. Again, it could be music, it could even be through some worldly music. Again, he meets you where you're at in your walk. If you are a person who may watch television, I don't too much watch television. He's been leading me away from that, but he has ways of getting your attention, really listening to the messages and being able to discern. You just know. Again, he speaks through nature, his creation, guys. The sun, the moon, we're called to be the light. The moon and the sun, they do shine. The moon shining in the midst of darkness. And I made a video about that. I'm gonna post that too. But yeah, it's just hopefully just encouragement, guys. A lot of people think that God don't speak to them. Well, God probably has been speaking to you many times. It's just you have not been paying attention, maybe because you was too into the world to really be able to hear him when he's trying to speak to you. Your mind and things just being clogged up with a lot of things of the world, which is why you got to really crucify your flesh, putting down what you want to do, spending time with him, just as you spend time with a friend. Like, how do you develop a relationship with someone? You spend time with them, you get to know them. It's the same thing with God. You get acquainted with him, get in his word, seek him in prayer. Not just 5 or 10 minutes, but actually taking the time to develop a relationship with him, guys. And you will start seeing results. You will start seeing change. You will start being more sensitive to the Holy Spirit. You'll grow stronger in your discernment the more you experience. And then, As a child of God, you just get that innate knowing when it's God speaking to you too. Sometimes we just deny, or sometimes we just cast it off because sometimes we may not want to hear what God may say because God's going to give us the brutal truth about things and it's going to cause us to change. And sometimes we're in our comfort zones and we don't want to do that, So following God will come with dying to self, which a lot of people don't like to do. It comes with making sacrifices. It comes with being transformed to His image. It's going to come with getting out the comfort zone. So sometimes we do block Him out when He's been speaking to us, and we know it. Out fear, things that we have to surrender, surrendering fear, because we know that everything that God tells us is for our good. He don't tell us anything to harm us, the one that causes pain. It can be painful when the flesh resists, but we know. And when God tells us something or speaks to us, it's always for our good because His plans are to prosper us, not to destroy us, guys, as His children. So you have to really just keep that in mind. Hopefully, you just find this message to just be encouraging. It comes with experiencing, experience not placing limits on God in the ways He chooses to speak, using that First John test. Remembering note that no spirit of Antichrist can acknowledge that Jesus came in the flesh, listening to that voice and what it may say after you ask that question. Just different ways, guys, of how you can go about testing the spirits when you're seeking things, taking things back to scripture to confirm what God has shown you. I want to also point out too, in the book of Luke, it was in the last chapter, they made a note how not everything that the Lord did was even written in the Bible. And I said that to say, there are some things that God may very well reveal to you if you're able to really discern and test the spirits. He may reveal some things to you that may not necessarily be in the Bible, all the things that He has done according to what has been stated in Luke. That's, the more you begin to discern and experience, you'll know. He'll give you the confirmation and the understanding. Your spirit, bears witness to what's true. But it is a matter of, rebuking the spirit of confusion because you will have demons who try to confuse you. They may try to give you commandments and things. You do have that religious spirit who tries to play God. Just really seeking the Lord in prayer, asking the Holy Spirit to reveal to you what is it that's in you that needs to come out, that needs to die off, and rebuking, binding up those demonic spirits when you are going into prayer so you can just really be in tune and discerning the things that God may tell you, testing it, guys, within the scriptures and taking it from there. So hopefully you find this message to be encouraging, edifying. If you have questions, feel free to comment. I'll answer to the best of my abilities, all according to the will of the Holy Spirit. So thank you for taking the time to listen, and you all be blessed.